back again. You're talking about the Henry Clay Warhawk. Now, Henry Clay Warhawk has a little bit of a story to it. Henry Clay was a gentleman, a statesman, back in the 1800s, that was very rebellious. He's kind of that guy that said, you know what? I got to do things just a little different. We were working and trying to get rid of the British out of our country. Government was working on it, but old Henry Clay, being a statesman in the end, said, you know, we want him out of here. I want to form an army to get him out. And then, government says, we're working with it. Henry Clay said, nope, not going to do it. He's rebellious. He formed an army, he got the British out. Well, we did a little bit of what his original blend was, the original Henry Clay, using a Connecticut broadleaf, and we went to a Connecticut shade, but being the rebellious side, we still had to keep a little bit of that Henry Clay in there, so we took a binder leaf and made the binder leaf a broadleaf, which is unusual. Nobody else does it as far as I know, using broadleaf as a binder. You have to go through a lot of extra fermentation with it, but by doing that, you create a lot more unique flavors that have been very, very well received. Guys are loving it. I know it's one of my great smokes for a medium body cigar. I find the flavors just pop, they're right there, not intrusive. Next, we're going to go ahead and talk about, we're going to come right back at you.